Hello everyone. I would like to start this presentation with a small story. Once Lord Indra got upset with farmers, he announced there will be no rain for 12 years and you won't be able to produce crops. Farmers begged for clemency from Lord Indra, who then said rain will be possible only if Lord Shiva plays his damru. When farmers reached Lord Shiva, he repeated the same thing. Disappointed farmers decided to wait for 12 years. But one farmer regularly was plowing the soil and sowing the seeds, even with no crop emerging. Other farmers were making fun of this farmer and after 3 years asked him, why was he wasting his time and energy? You know that rain will not be coming before 12 years. He replied, I know that crop won't come out, but I am doing it so I do not forget the process of growing seeds. And also do not forget the habit of going to the fields. Hearing this argument, Goddess Parvati praised this version to Lord Shiva and asked him if he should check his damru if he remembers how to play it. The innocent Lord Shiva in his anxiety tried to play the damru, and hearing the sound of damru, immediately there was rain, and the farmer who was regularly working in the field immediately got his harvest, while others were disappointed. What we learn from here is we cannot stop working and growing. We need to improvise and continue to do the best we can in any situation. When we talk of digital transformation in Indian scenario, India is far behind than the other developed nations. According to a study, 97% of businesses in US are already on cloud today. What has triggered digital transformation in Indian scenario? The most recent I can remember is demonetization, GST, digital wallets, and of course, online shopping was picking up in a big way in our country. Especially the GST department came up with loads of reports at micro level, which was not possible without systems. And now it is COVID that is showing new ways to work, that is work from anywhere. According to a study, 87% of the companies think digital transformation is important for their competitiveness. But the real challenge is less than 50% of the executive workforce lack familiarity with technology like analytics, automation, cloud, IoT, etc. And in today's scenario, when we are facing crisis and uncertainty, almost 75% of companies worldwide have reported supply chain disruption as a result of COVID-19. In today's scenario, the resources will be very limited, and depending on the supply, they may also be expensive. COVID or no COVID, business will continue to run at 25% to 50% capacity for an extended period of time. So the question here is how to scale with less resources and stay efficient. From a software standpoint, the answer is we will need to swiftly look for a solution that is user-friendly, easy to learn, and definitely online. Our customers already online did their book closing, finished their data entry backlogs, internal audits. Our customer in Chicory business was in the middle of harvest season and was able to do all his purchases related transactions with farmers. We have to remember resources will be limited and resources may not get regular in office, so enable them with online tools so you can get what you need. You will need all types of reports and need to manage red flags remotely from the safety of your home. So get online, set up your checkpoints with the help of software to make it easy for you. I would like to quickly share a few challenges during the crisis and also some suggestions. How do you plan to move your cash flow? Look into your debtor reports. Send the customers follow-up by SMS, email, WhatsApp. Software can help automate all these and save a lot of your time. If possible, maybe give your customers option to pay online. This will definitely help reduce your outstanding. Look into your inventory aging reports. Identify the inventory not moving since 180 days and find ways to liquidate or shift it to some better location so that it can move faster. Next is customer retention and exploring new markets. New customer will be very important. Market will be volatile and demands will be completely unpredictable. You will have to have some product costing handy to recalculate your margins and win the deals. You have to keep suppliers database ready so that if your primary supplier is not able to give you support, you can dig into old suppliers and their rates it is important exercise to do. Upload your data on a tool, a CRM tool, so that you can make things more efficient. CRM tool will also come handy if you have a sales team, because they will not be coming to office for some time. So leads can be captured online and ensure that your team does not miss on the follow-up of leads. If you can run FSN analysis on your inventory, you can plan your stocks based on fast-moving items and may not buy or block your capital on other items. If you are invoicing through an online software, then set up credit limits centrally so that you can control your market exposure. These are small action points using softwares that can be very helpful in streamlining the business during this crisis period. This is the type of lead management I am talking about. During this crisis period, utilize your resources. Morally, you are paying them. At least get your leads consolidated on a system so that you can properly review them, advise your sales team accordingly, and also you will not miss on the follow-ups, because missing leads now can be very costly. It is your experience in managing your business. You need to tightly run, closely watch your daily operations, and your ability to respond fast in the volatile market will help you emerge strong. And this can only happen with the help of software. And you can stay ahead of your competition. Next is, give your distributors, sub-distributors, and customers a digital platform. I will like to share one of my case studies. It is very relevant for today. This customer is into imports and selling his products through his distribution channel across the country. Today, the channels are totally disconnected and not functional, or functioning in a limited capacity. He is not able to reach out to end customers and meet their demands. And distributors will also not work in full swing post-crisis and may not be willing to go for digital also. He has immediately implemented our dealer portal to receive orders from end customers via his distribution channels. He kept the interest of the distributors intact ethically, as the system is attributing sales to the distributors and sub-distributors automatically when the end customer is placing orders. He is now able to get proper demand visibility in real time and accordingly planning his procurement and logistics. He has reduced huge amount of workload and manual intervention in this whole process. So changing with time is very, very important. Pay as you go is the new trend. Do not invest into anything upfront. Now people will be extra careful in making capital investments. You need to quickly get on a platform that has payment flexibility. It is online, on cloud, and gives you full data security, auto backups, like access from anywhere, such kind of features. Saves your time in recording or reconciling data by connecting with third-party softwares, can fetch orders from online marketplaces and generate invoice for you on a click. And most importantly of all, very friendly, easy to learn, and well supported. Remember that enterprise software will give you best ROI only if it is well supported by the service provider. So what are the options? What should we choose? Yes, Expand ERP is the solution that can truly transform your business. It can give all the technological edge your business needs, from cloud to mobile app to integration, you name it, and it's there. It has been designed specially for manufacturers who are expanding their reach by exploring all channels of sales like exports, wholesale, retail, and online. The software binds all channels seamlessly and centrally on the cloud with excellent visibility and analytics. Expand ERP is completely developed in India for Indian work environment with over 15 years of R&D and continuous customer feedback. The software is very stable and deep in functionality related to manufacturing, export, retail, and online businesses. It is easy to use, user-friendly, and Expand ERP has been pioneer in remote implementations. Most rollouts pan-India has been done remotely by our team. When we say manufacturing, surely we mean all types of manufacturing. It is highly configurable, highly flexible, IoT-enabled, and Expand team offers full customizations to ensure that business gets maximum return on investment. We have seen multiple unforeseen hurdles in our business, like demonetization, rapid statutory changes, and now work from home. It is high time that we modernize our business applications, otherwise it will be too late. Expand ERP can give you that peace of mind, keeping your data fully secured with help of banking level encryptions and automated backup in different geographical locations. The team ensures 24/7 call support, remote support, desktop support, so that your business is undisrupted. And when I say pay as you go is the new trend, pay as you realize the benefits. Thank you for watching this presentation. If you want to know more about us, visit our website www.expanderp.com. Someone has rightly said that don't fear change, embrace it. Thank you.